What's up? My name is Fokis, and I'd like to welcome y'all to episode 4 of Fokis on the Box Owners. In this episode, we take it to Phalanx CrossFit in North Carolina, New London CrossFit in Connecticut, and CrossFit Inferno in California. Check it out.
What is your name and the name of this box?
I am Tammy Lucart, and this is Phalanx CrossFit.
Mike Penta, the box is New London CrossFit.
My name is Bill Grundler, and this is CrossFit Inferno.
How long have you guys been open?
9 years now, 8 or 9 years. I think we're on 9 years now.
7 years.
We've been open since 2008.
Is this something that you do full time?
It's not.
Yes.
Yeah, it is now.
What did you do before this?
I'm in the reserve, and then I'm also a military contractor.
So I've been in the fitness industry for 15 years, so I've been doing since college. I actually started when I was in college.
I retired early from fire, and now this is my full-time deal here.
Well, so you were a fireman before, awesome. And what made you get into CrossFit?
So when I was in the Army, when I was active duty, I was in the air assault course, and I was in pretty good shape. There was a guy there who was just amazing at everything. He just smoked the rest of us. He was so much better. And I pulled him aside and said, "What do you do?" This was 2009, I think. I said, "What do you do?" And he said, "CrossFit."
I actually had a friend that was at Coach Glassman's original gym. And probably around 2002, he actually said, "Hey, you should check out this website. There's like free workouts on it. Give it a try, see what you think. I know you like crazy workouts." And I did some of them, but I didn't really get it. I didn't understand the reason behind it. So I would do my regular buys and tries on Mondays and leg day and, you know, all that kind of stuff, the normal workout stuff. And then I read the What Is Fitness document that Coach Glassman wrote. And that was the light bulb that really made me go, "Okay, I'm in."
I was playing, you know, college football. I got done playing college football. One of my trainers that was working for me at the time said, you know, he actually introduced it to me. He's like, "Hey, man, you got to try this workout." I tried it, and I was, like, just smoked in 15 minutes, less than 15 minutes. So to me, I was got to the point where I was like, I really need to learn a little bit more about this and kind of go a little deeper in with it, so.
Have you guys sent any athletes to the regionals or the games?
So I went to the games on a team in 2010.
Ooh.
And I went to regionals in 11, 12, and 13. And then I started making babies.
What?
So yeah. I haven't gotten back yet.
A couple athletes that have made it to the CrossFit Games, they were on another team. Alex and Taylor are members here. They made it to regionals, they made it to the games.
There they are.
I guess that's a yes.
Masters athletes. We've had one open athlete. Me and my brother have both gone in the Masters. We've had a team that's gone to regionals almost every year.
What is your favorite food?
My favorite food is pizza.
Nothing healthy, please.
I'm Italian, so I would have to say either my mom's homemade lasagna or manicotti.
Okay.
Sushi. Sweets, I can eat ice cream. If I can eat sushi and ice cream every single day, I'd probably be a very happy person.
What is your best Fran time?
2:14.
Whew, that's club elite.
3:03.
2012, 2013, one of those, it was 2:17. Whew. Yeah, I was really good at one point.
And what's your least favorite benchmark workout?
Race. There is something about that 95-pound clean and jerk. It just crushes my soul. I hate it.
Lisa, if you had to say to someone who was on the fence thinking about CrossFit, hesitant, what would you say to them?
The only way to really find out about it is you got to come in and try it.
I would just try CrossFit.
I'd say you have to try it.
So I had a great time at all of these boxes, and I highly suggest you check them out if you're ever in town. I thought each box was unique in their own special way. Phalanx CrossFit was a really nice box, really community-oriented, it's like one big family over there, and the athletes were really, really good. CrossFit Inferno was actually one of the first boxes affiliated. What stood out to me over there was actually the warm-up, man. Coach Grundler, he really, really put us through an extensive warm-up, and it was long, but it was good, and that really stood out to me. Great programming, and he gave me some good pointers too. New London CrossFit was a great, great place as well. The WOD was excellent. It was a partner WOD, and I actually had the pleasure of teaming up with my man Alex, who's a CrossFit Games athlete, and he pushed me to the limit. Great place, man. They have a lot of members over there, and one of the first boxes in Connecticut as well. You don't have to do CrossFit, but do something. All right? See y'all later. Peace.
you got wind of my story, what were your immediate thoughts?
Savage.
I thought it was cool. I thought it was interesting. I thought it was cool. Yeah, I was curious about you and happy to meet you.
Awesome. Well, I want to thank
you've been a great visitor, by the way.
Well,
thank you. You
guys worked me today, that's for sure.
It's been really cool. Like, the story is cool. The intent is cool. The transformation is unbelievable, undeniable. And I can't wait to see what the documentary looks like.
Awesome.
Savage. I think anybody, I told you, that journey is a tough journey to make. Weight loss isn't easy, especially the amount of weight loss that you were trying to accomplish right now. Keep grinding, that's all I can say. Because once you hit that number, just keep grinding.
Bam.